Black holes and revelations, I guess. But as a Muse plug aside, the very nature of these cosmic anomalies is the stuff of hypothetical legend, because it's no secret that we humans are equal parts intrigued and equal parts terrified by the reality-bending mechanics of what black holes are, what they could be, and what they're going to do. Because if we're correct, at the end of all things, only black holes will remain. But until then, as the question is so often raised, can we do anything to combat the eater of worlds, the singularity, the black hole? Or do we just have to close our eyes, avoid their gaze, and hope that they will just fizzle out on their own? Let's find out. Hello, internet, what's going on? And once again, welcome back to the most inquisitive channel on YouTube, Life's Biggest Questions. As per usual, I'll be your disembodied floating voice, Jack Finch, as today we curiously ask the question, can a black hole be destroyed? Roll the clip. That scene gets me every time. But for the curious amongst you, that clip was from Danny Boyle's 2007 science fiction work of art, Sunshine, starring the remarkable Cillian Murphy as a physicist whose mission is to literally blow up the sun with a nuke. And I don't know about you, but I'm pretty sure that sounds like a quickfire way to get yourself the particular cosmic construct in question of this video. Now, obviously, that's a pretty loose connection, and that's also not how it works, but hey, this is a hypothetical of science, and as far as science fiction goes, Sunshine is a phenomenal film. But it leads us to our first and most important point when addressing this question. Can a black hole be destroyed? Well, you see, as Sun Tzu so famously said, if you know the enemy and know yourself, you need not fear the result of 100 battles. Or, as Zach de la Rocha also more succinctly said, know your enemy, dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun-dun. So, then it would make sense that if we're wanting to address the question of finally putting an end to a black hole, we must, more importantly, need to understand how and why they are created. The whole process first begins with a pretty special star, one that adheres to the Chan-Rasekhar limit, a star that has a minimum mass of 1.6 times the mass of our Sun. As this star reaches the end of its life and thus begins to run out of the hydrogen and helium fuel which it uses to power itself, the gravity which holds it together gradually takes over entirely, and it shrinks to such a tiny size, and as it crosses its predefined Schwarzschild radius, there we have a newly formed black hole. Obviously, there's a lot more to it, but as you may have imagined, we're more concerned with how and even if we can destroy these cosmic destroyers. The thing is, in several ways, the answer to this question is surprisingly mundane. You see, a black hole's biggest enemy is itself, and in many ways, it may be the only way for it to finally bring about its own demise. Now listen, don't worry, we're going to be taking a stab in the dark at a few potential spacefaring tactics to take down a black hole, but the first and most important void elephant in the room that we need to address is the fact that each and every black hole is pretty much slowly dying already anyway. Let me introduce you to a little thing known as Hawking radiation. Back in 1974, the legendary mind of British physicist Stephen Hawking harnessed the quantum mechanics of the science of the very small to theorize that each and every black hole gradually loses its own mass. Hawking radiation is based on a well-established phenomenon called quantum fluctuations of the vacuum. Essentially, Hawking turned his gaze to the very edge of the black hole, the event horizon, where particles and antiparticles continuously create and destroy each other. Yeah, black holes, am I right? The thing is though, right at the edge of this occurrence, Hawking noticed that if these particles and antiparticles are positioned just right, there is a slight possibility that one of the particles could escape the black hole's gravitational pull whilst its counterpart falls inward. And there we have, in essence, Hawking radiation, a slow leak that is inevitably reducing the black hole's mass, thus leading it to be destroyed, the largest of which will be in about 6 times 10 to the power of 99 years, which is, yeah, that's a long time, guys. We're talking quadrillions upon quadrillions of years. But don't worry, the heat death of the universe will have already occurred, and there'll only be black holes left to witness the utter abyss of the end of all things. Ah, sorry about that. So is that it? To destroy a black hole, do we just wait for it to destroy itself? I mean, we wouldn't be around to witness its demise, but hey, at least we can rest easy knowing that it would be destroyed. Eventually, that is, I guess. Well, I'm not sure about you, but maybe there's another way. Now, if you're an astute observer of Life's Biggest Question, you'll know that we've hypothetically envisioned all manners of how to bring about the end of these cosmic destroyers, most infamously being that time where we wondered what would happen if you shot a nuke straight into it. Yeah. And, yeah, as you may imagine, just like Godzilla himself, all of these battle tactics have only ever served to make them even more angry. Nukes, cosmic tornadoes, lions, tigers and bears, all of which only serve to strengthen the combined power of a black hole, given the fact that in the singularity, energy is mass and mass is energy, and throwing in either of the two simply feeds it like the terrifying, ravenous cosmic maw that it is. Alright then, in that case, it's probably time to up the ante. Let's bring out the big guns with everyone's favourite anomaly, antimatter. And as the name suggests, antimatter is exactly that, the opposite of regular matter. And as we're also taught by mathematics, if we add a positive and a negative together, they just cancel each other out, right? So why don't we just create our own black hole out of antimatter, fire it into the black hole, and then call this whole thing a day, dust off our shoulders, and move on to the next cosmic villain. Well, it's not that easy. Just ask the folks over at CERN who operate the Large Hadron Collider, a particle accelerator which fires tiny particles against each other in the effort of creating all manners of cosmic entities. But the thing is, the cost of creating something out of antimatter is, well, it's pretty damn staggering. NASA speculates that a single gram of anti-hydrogen would cost around $62.5 trillion, and that's under the presumption that scientists had already worked out the math in the effort to smash together these incredibly expensive anti-hydrogen particles in the effort of creating an antimatter black hole. And that's also without addressing the fact that, under those circumstances, we would have created an antimatter black hole on our own planet. And I'm pretty certain I don't need to illustrate just exactly why that would be a very bad thing. You see, even if we did manage to safely do that and then somehow figured a way to catapult an antimatter black hole into a regular black hole, then the result would be an explosion of pure energy. It would be the most perfect weapon of pure energy that theoretical physics can envision. And yeah, I hate to break it to you, but we just get twice the black hole. E equals mc squared. As soon as that explosion occurred, all of that energy would immediately be converted into, well, more black hole. Yeah, sorry guys, but it's probably best that we just wait this one out. Hawking radiation, yeah, it's our only hope. Well, there we have it, our long and short answer to the question, can a black hole be destroyed? Not really, but also yes, we just won't be around to see it. What do you guys think? Do you agree, disagree, have any more to add to this particular Life's Biggest Question? Then let us know any intriguing insights you have down in the comment section below. Before we depart from today's video, let's first take a quick look at some of your more creative comments from the past few days. First up, Dr. Confirm says, what if my socks would stop disappearing when I do laundry? Well, Dr. Confirm, I mean, I'm pretty sure that is a Life's Biggest Question, and it's one that I wouldn't even attempt to answer. Beats me, dude. It's the eternal question. And finally, Jesus Martinez says, short answer, existential crisis. Yeah, you could pretty much apply that to every single LBQ, right? Yeah, daily dose of existential crisis. Well, on that existential note, that's what we've got time for in today's video. Cheers, stick around all the way until the end. If you were a fan of this video, or just Life's Biggest Questions in general, then please be a dear and hit that thumbs up button, as well as that subscribe bell, and I'll be seeing you in the next one. As per usual, I've been your disembodied floating voice, Jack Finch. You've been watching Life's Biggest Questions, and until next time, you take it easy.